Hey everyone, my name is Ryan. This is Ask the Pastor. The internet sends me questions and I answer them as well as I can. Today's question is, what are the essentials of salvation? It's a good question. It's an important question. It's one of the, I think, most central or important questions we start to ask as we familiarize ourselves with Christian theology and Christianity itself. It's one thing to be saved, but then what are the elements of my belief that are absolutely essential for being saved? What part of my church is just a preference versus what part of my church is necessary? And if I don't have that, I miss out. Well, in order to answer that question really well, I think I should ask you, salvation from what? What kind of salvation are we talking about? It's important to get that word right, because I would argue it's not always meaning the same thing everywhere in the Bible that it's talked about. Some places in the Bible, people are saved from political oppression or from slavery. Sometimes they're saved from sin guilt. Sometimes they're saved from the propensity to sin. They don't want to do that anymore. But I think I can interpolate here and say that mainly what we're worried about is not going to hell when we die. That's usually when we start out in Christianity, when we're asking questions like that, the terms we're taught to think in, which aren't necessarily the best terms, but it's still a question, and it's a valid question, and we want to engage it. So I want to teach you a couple of verses. The first one I would go to is, well, the classic one, is Romans TNT. That's Romans 10, 9, and 10. That says, if you believe in your heart that Jesus is Lord and confess with your mouth that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. Now, what that tells us is that that's enough. It's not necessary to have a comprehensive understanding of the Trinity. It's not necessary to have a good Bible-believing church that you are active in. Those things are good things, and I hope you do get them, but you shall be saved if you believe in your heart Jesus is Lord and confess with your mouth that God raised him from the dead. There's another verse that I like even better, and that comes in Acts 16:31. It says, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and you shall be saved, you and your household. Acts 16:30 is a jailer asking Paul and Silas, sirs, what must I do to be saved? A miracle happens. Paul and Silas, these early followers of Jesus, are at the jail. They're ready to go free, and they don't. And the jailer's like, teach me, sensei. Like, what do I have to do to be saved? They say, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and you shall be saved, you and your household. So that has actually even less than the Romans verse, right? It has Jesus in it, and it has Lord, which seems to be important, that Jesus is Lord. You believe that, and then you are saved. Well, what does it mean for Jesus to be Lord? Could I, for instance, believe in Jesus without knowing that he's called Jesus, right? Could I believe? And I think it's pretty obvious that, say, I call him Jesus, right? I speak Spanish, and I know Jesus by a different name. There's nothing in that particular English pronunciation of that word that saves me. What is it that's essential about the person of Jesus that I need to believe in or trust in? Well, that he's Savior, right? That he's the person I believe in to be saved. So to me, that implies a certain element of, I need help. I need help that comes from outside of myself. I am not enough for my own salvation, but I need God to help me. But of course, your understanding of God, it doesn't have to be a perfect theology. It doesn't have to be a perfect understanding. And we have to believe that this Jesus is Lord. Lord means God. The word that's used, kurios, implies God, the way it is used in the New Testament, because those four letters that we use for Lord, those are a substitute for the four letters in God's first name, Yahweh. But it also implies boss, that Jesus is in charge. And so to believe that Jesus is in charge of me is something that I need to do to be saved, to believe that Jesus is rightfully the boss of the universe and indeed the boss of my life. So these are concepts related to salvation. And I know that I haven't exactly scratched the very bottom of the barrel there. There are some interpretive differences. How are we going to interpret Romans TNT? How are we going to interpret Acts 16:31 in order to get the very kernel, essential bottom limit? But that's not really productive to do anyway. I mean, how hard is it? Believe that Jesus is Lord, and you will be saved. Now, an interesting thing is going to happen when we do that. Because actually, at the beginning when I said, hey, you should really be able to answer, what do you mean by saved? How saved is saved enough? By believing in the Lord Jesus Christ in differing degrees, right? We get saved from different things. So perhaps there is some bare minimum amount of faith that is necessary, some bare minimum affirmation or belief that if I check the box, then I don't go to hell when I die. Well, how boring. But okay, so I believe in Jesus, and I've heard of him. He seems like a cool guy. He should be in charge. I don't really know what he teaches. I don't know how to follow him, but that's enough for God. I don't go to hell when I die. Whoopee. Okay, but what if I do know some more about Jesus? And when I believe, there's some knowledge associated with that. Well, then that helps me. That actually can save me from suffering here and now. If I know about the things that Jesus taught and I believe in Jesus in the sense that I take his advice, well, then that will save me from unemployment, drug addiction, issues that I might otherwise run into if I weren't obeying Jesus at that time and in that place. Now, it's worth mentioning, none of us obey Jesus completely, and none of us avoid all suffering all the time or all earthly suffering. And even if we did, there's some suffering that's going to hit us like a truck anyway. But that there's another level of salvation that's possible with another level of belief in more of Jesus. Well, what else? What if I have a great deal of belief in Jesus and he really is Lord and he's Lord of my life? I don't just believe that he's rightly Lord, but I really make him my boss so that every decision that I make is informed by a personal relationship that I have with Jesus Christ, who is this person that I've spent a lot of time getting to know. Well, that's actually going to help me with my sin problem, with my propensity to sin, with the fact that even though I might get away with it after I die, not get eternally punished for like the immoral things I've done, I still don't like hurting people. Hurting people makes me feel bad, but I keep doing it and I keep making these selfish decisions. But by allowing Jesus to be Lord of my life, I am saved from it. So all of these different increasing levels of salvation from more and more things are available to me from that just very small phrase, Jesus is Lord. And as a pastor, I am striving more and more every day to know more fully the truth of the statement that Jesus is Lord, to believe more than I believed yesterday that Jesus is Lord, to make him more Lord and to know him more fully. And that to me is a lot more exciting than finding the bottom of Jesus is Lord. The most essential piece for the smallest amount of salvation is to know the breadth and the depth of the love of Jesus, to believe as much as I can that Jesus is Lord and put as much other stuff around that that belongs around that as I can so I can be saved from more and more. and more. I hope this answers your question. If this answered your question, whether you're the person who asked it or not, I want to encourage you to share this video. Put it on social media, some social media that you use. You can even send it around by email if you're an email person, and let people know, hey, this was a good answer to this question. I think you'll enjoy this guy. If it didn't answer your question, or if you think I'm wrong, I hope you'll argue with me. We can talk about it. It doesn't have to be like a contentious thing. We can have a discussion and build a relationship. There's a time when so many of us are divided. Hey, here's a talking head. Let's talk to each other. And finally, if you would like to see me answer other questions, I've got them up here. You can even send your own question, and I'll answer that. Thank you.